Are new COVID vaccines better at fighting variants? The pandemic seems far from over, so drug makers are developing newer vaccines to fight Omicron or the next major variant. But will newer vaccines do much good versus the coronavirus? According to the WHO, there are only two variants of concern. They are Delta and Omicron, with the latter having 5 subvariants. That's right, Omicron has 5 subvariants, namely BA.1, BA.2, BA.3, BA.4, and BA.5. This is why we need a game changer against them. In the conversation, pharmaceutical science experts Vaibhav Upadhyay and Krishna Malela at the University of Colorado Anschutz Medical Campus answered questions about newer COVID-19 vaccines. First, why are companies working on them? Because of emerging variants. We lack a single solution versus the spike protein mutations in every variant. Plus, we don't exactly know what mutations the next variant will have. When predictions are off, the vaccines will unlikely be effective. Second, what vaccine types are in development? There are 195 in the works globally, and 41 of them are in clinical trials in the US. Of 41, 15 use the viral vector design, 5 use the protein-based design, and 17 others with RNA and DNA techs. Third, are newer versions better than current ones? If you don't know, current vaccines were created using the original strain, the starter version of SARS-CoV-2 in humans. We are so behind and need a serious update to catch up. Moderna already launched a newer version that includes mRNA from Beta and Omicron variants, and it seemed better than the original shot. However, there are vaccine techs that don't need such an update to stay relevant like whole virus vaccines. Fourth, what are the pros of whole virus vaccines? Compared to mRNA and protein-based vaccines, which use the spike protein alone, whole virus vaccines include other parts of the virus as well. This lets the immune system learn more about the enemy. So when the wild version arrives, the body is faster at recognizing the intruder and unleashing its firepower against it. Plus, whole virus vaccines are easier to ship and store than mRNAs. And finally, what are the cons of whole virus vaccines? Vaccine makers need to disable a significant number of the coronavirus. There's a risk in doing that. Also, these vaccines are not so effective in protecting immunocompromised patients and are quite laborious to produce. We may have the means to produce better vaccines for emerging variants. However, the balance between effectiveness and cost is so sensitive. This is one reason why different vaccines are in the works and why some research groups are looking for inexpensive and better alternatives. Is the vaccine type important to you? If so, what vaccine type do you prefer? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.